Hello students, so today we are going to learn derivatives using logarithms. So already you studied logarithms in the first PUC. So just recall, okay, some properties, only three properties of logarithms. Then I'll show you how to use logarithms in derivatives. Okay, it is not derivatives of logarithmic function, derivatives using logarithms. Okay, so the first formula you should remember, okay, it's log of m into n to the base e. It is log m to the base a plus log of n to the base a. First, you remember this formula, okay, you know already. So log of m by n to the base a equal to log of m to the base a minus log of n to the base a. One more formula you should know, log of m power n to the base a equal to n into log of m to the base a. Along with this, two standard logarithm you should remember. First one, log of 1 to the base a is always 0, and the next one, log of a to the base a is equal to 1. So with this 5 information, I'm going to explain how to use logarithm in derivatives, and I'll explain why this is required, okay, in differentiation. So I'll take one example, no other theory, okay, this only 5 formulas you remember. I'll explain with the one example. Suppose you want to differentiate this y is equal to sine x into x square plus 1 by 3x plus 1 into cos x. Suppose you want to differentiate this directly. So what are the different rules are required? Quotient rule is required, product rule is required, product rule required 2 times. So its direct differentiation is seriously very lengthy. But this can be a very simple differentiation if you use a logarithm. What is these 5 properties actually? Observe carefully. The first property will be converting the product into addition. Second property will be converting the division into difference. And the next one, finding the exponential function, converting exponential function into the product. So these 3 properties of logarithm will convert the difficult part into easy part. Difficult part into easy part. See, when you compare with the product and addition, which is the difficult part? Product. Which is the easy part? Addition. So here multiplication, here addition. So I hope you can observe that. And I already told once, so you may not find difficult to understand this. So remember, the product will be converted into addition, division will be converted into difference. So using first 2 properties, I'll show you, okay, how this work can be very simple in derivatives. As it is, you can differentiate, no doubt. But if you differentiate directly, quotient rule is required, product rule is required, product rule required 2 times. So it's very lengthy. Now observe carefully. I'll show you how to use logarithm, and also you will understand how logarithm will help you to convert the difficult part into the easy part. Observe carefully. First, you should take log on both sides. First, you should take log on both sides. So take log on both sides like this. To any base, if I'm not right, okay, in calculus, it will be considered as E. I hope you remember that. Okay. Log of, write everything as it is. Okay. 3x plus 1 into cos x. Now, use these properties one by one. First, this is a product. According to logarithm, the product will convert into, tell me, yes, addition. Next comes, after this product, you will get difference. According to the second property, the difference will be converted into division will be converted into difference. So this division will convert into some minus. Then, since outside minus sign, put one bracket. Again, you will get product. So product will convert into addition. Put bracket, otherwise you will lose this one minus sign here. So now, this is ready to differentiate. This is ready to differentiate. What is the differentiation of log y? See, what is the differentiation of log x? Did you remember? I gave already this in the beginning. Differentiation of log x is 1 by x. So because of this, observe carefully, differentiation of log y with respect to x is 1 by y. See, you saw this in implicit function differentiation. Here you will get dy by dx. See, this is not visible in the above one because it will be 1, but here it is not equal to 1, so it will come. So be careful. So according to this, log y is 1 by y into dy by dx equal to, using chain rule, first outside function, that is log, differentiation of log x, 1 by x, so 1 by sin x, differentiation of sin x is cos x, plus 1 by x square plus 1, then differentiation of x square 2x, differentiation of 1 is 0, minus log of 3x plus 1, 1 by 3x plus 1 into differentiation of 3x plus 1, which is only 3, minus plus minus 1 by cos x into minus sin x. Got it? Differentiation is over. Now you're going to simplify this expression. So it will be 1 by y into dy by dx is equal to cos x by sin x is cot x plus 2x divided by x square plus 1 minus 3 divided by 3x plus 1 minus minus plus sin x by cos x is tan x. So therefore, dy by dx is equal to, y will come to the right hand side, so y into cot x plus 2x by x square plus 1 minus 3 by 3x plus 1 plus tan x. So this will be the answer to the given expression. I did this differentiation without using anywhere quotient rule and product rule. So main purpose of logarithm in differentiation is to avoid quotient rule and product rule. I hope you understood. This is one problem. I'll take another problem. Again, for this type of problem, compulsory you should use logarithm. Here you may have some alternate method, but for the next question, there is no alternate method. Compulsory you should use these properties before differentiation. And that particular example is like this. Suppose you want to differentiate x to the power sin x. Suppose you want to differentiate x to the power sin x. Remember, up now we didn't do any such things, okay, in the derivatives, so that you can find the derivative of this directly. We don't have any formulas. We don't have any method to differentiate this directly. This must be solved using the properties of logarithm. In the previous problem, you use first and second property, right? For this particular problem, you should use the third property because this is an exponential. And after using logarithm, exponential will convert into product. So that is the main idea. So before this, okay, differentiation, you should take log on both sides. That I'm not writing again, take log on both sides. So directly take log on both sides. Okay. Now this exponential will become the product. Sin x will be multiplied. Which property I'm using? Log of m power n to the base a is n into log of m, sin x into log x. Now this is ready to differentiate. As you know, log y differentiation is 1 by y into dy by dx equal to, see, this is the product of two functions. Remember that it's a product of two functions. So how you should differentiate? Using product rule. I hope you remember. Sin x into differentiation of log x. What is that differentiation of log x? 1 by x plus log x into differentiation of sin x, you know, cos x. That's it. So therefore, final answer, dy by dx is equal to y into, y will be multiplying, sin x by x plus log x into cos x. Further simplification definitely not required. But this problem can be solved like this only. Remember that. Okay, you don't have any formula in derivatives to differentiate directly. You should take log on both sides. Use that this third property, log of m power n, okay, then simplify, differentiate and simplify. I hope you understood. Okay, let me take one more problem, then I'll proceed with the textbook problems. Okay, one more example. Suppose question is like this, y is equal to log of log x to the power x square plus 1. Which rule is required again? Can we differentiate directly? Definitely not, because it is an exponential function. So take log on both sides. Log of log x to the power x square plus 1. So property number third, x square plus 1 into log of log x. Not just log x into log x, it is log of log x. What is the left hand side? Log y. So it is 1 by y into dy by dx is equal to product rule. This is u, this is v. Product rule as well as chain rule. So what is the rule? X square plus 1, differentiation of this is 1 by log x into differentiation of log x is 1 by x. Chain rule, I hope remember. Maybe you remember I told chain rule is required in all the remaining part of derivatives. See here, you can observe that. Plus log of log x into derivative of x square plus 1, that is 2x. Derivative of 1 is 0. So the final answer is y into x square plus 1 by x into log x plus 2x into log of log x. So this is a method to find out derivative of the exponential form like this. Okay, now in next video I'm going to give you one formula to differentiate these type of expression. It's nothing but using logarithm only, but every time no need to take log on both sides. Okay, in the beginning you practice like this. After getting that formula, you can directly write the answer to this one in one step. But these types of problem you must solve like this only. So this three example will help you to understand why logarithm is required to find out derivative of the sum functions. Understood? Very good. Thank you.